I'm live. What's up, you guys? Okay. Welcome to Mr. Liv. Love, Laugh, and Triple L the Great. Please like the video. What's up, you guys? I'm going to start off with a little song. Yeah, we're going to do the Kevin Hunter, Wendy Williams, T. He went live to tell y'all exactly what's on his mind. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Please, 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 please. I'm going to eat this apple pie here. Before that, y'all run up these strings on Apple Music and Spotify. Run up Blick Blick.
Like me, keep on wishing, baby. Bust it open first, you got to kiss it, baby. Yeah, want another nigga, I go fishing, baby. Yeah, I never let these broke ass niggas fix me, baby. Yeah, I hop on top and ride that dick, he act it lazy. Get that pussy, soak it wet, it's dripping like the Navy. Yeah, I call him Big Daddy, he call me Lil Baby. I'm the shit, I need some tissue, baby. Hey, holla, 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 all these diamonds different color, color, color. I done run up.
Congratulations to Nicki Minaj for hitting almost a million units of Do We Have a Problem. Turn it down. We're gonna go ahead and play the Kevin Hunter, Wendy Williams.
Can y'all hear me now? Can y'all hear me now? All right, we good? We gonna get through this. There's a few technical difficulties as I figure this out. But as I was saying, hold on, let me let it get a little more. We all can hear. Greetings, everyone coming in here. Health and wellness to everyone. It's been a trying time. I want to give an amazing thank you and support to the people at Hunter Publishing Group, the whole team, Rachel, Nicola, everybody that's helped on this journey. Even the brother Omar Tyree gave me some insight, gave me some game. Shouts to you, my brother. And definitely a big shout to Tamika Scott from the group Escape. She has an amazing product coming out in June, cookbook, A Taste of the South. Y'all, it's infused with family and love, and all the recipes are amazing. I want to give a special shout out to Sonia Aline with our I Kick Ass at Work book. Currently available at Hunter Publishing Group now.com, Hunter Publishing Group. And she's another amazing author. We have a lot coming in to show y'all in the form of hopefully great, powerful pieces of literature. Hopefully timeless.
Let me go find out.
So thank you. I tip my hat to y'all. I'm going to definitely start this with saying, you know, for the people that genuinely, you know what I'm saying, have been showing and giving nothing but support since I came on this gram and the hard journey that it still is sometimes, I want to, you know, salute, toast y'all with water, make sure y'all hydrate. I'm blessed to be in some great weather. Where you're getting enough vitamin D and sun and, you know, making sure everything is good. You know, that's important. You know what I mean? Don't stay dark. Go to the light. For a lot of people that don't know me, you know, I normally stay in the back. I have been fortunate enough, coming from Brownsville, Brooklyn, to have gone on a journey, been part of greatness, appreciative, humble. You know, you're talking to, you're looking at somebody with a 10th grade education, GED. And what I've been able to learn and also gather and teach myself, I've been fortunate. There's a few things I want to kind of address. I'm not going to take up too much of everybody's time, but if people that are here, you know, share, but these are, you know, my words. When it comes to whatever narratives that might be spun out there, God and me, my entire family. I want to first and foremost say that, you know, I respect, I truly respect and appreciate all that I was able to experience with my ex-wife and what we were able to accomplish. What she has accomplished clearly on her own, through her own merit, and what we were able to accomplish together. There has been, also with that, when it comes to my personal life, my professional life, when it comes to my personal life, of what the public has been able to see in real time, I take full accountability for my actions and understanding, you know, how I might have hurt a lot of people who witnessed seeing, at the time, one of the only black families in daytime television. So I understand how passionate that people have been passionate through the years, even before I came into the picture, and continue. There's haters that turned into lovers. There was a lot of hard work that was put in around the clock that only me and her will understand before all the hoorah and where it went. So I don't expect a lot of people to understand what sacrifice really means when you're going for something, or when you want to fulfill your mate at the time's dreams. Only real dudes will can relate to this. When you meet somebody and you know you really want to see them excel, and you put it on the line for them. To the point where you put yourself in the back because you want your queen to shine. That's like, that was the real narrative. And what came out of that, regardless of what anybody would think, was something extraordinary. The sacrifices that we made to put all of that in front of the foundation that is family was something that we suffered and we succumbed to, you know. And I will agree that, you know, for a large part of it, you know, when you're in the trenches doing things, you know, some of it is karma. And even though from where a lot of you people see it, you see it as, well, yeah, you started to come, you did it. Well, it was deeper than that. And I'm not gonna go, I'm being as forthright as I choose to be, but making the real people here understand what it takes when you really sacrifice and you go all in. See, I was all in. And I was given the opportunity to do that, coming from straight hustle and ingenuity and using my attributes to the best of my ability. You know what I mean? And for people who know, they know. For people who don't know, you know, I'm not gonna over explain that. But the opportunity that someone gave me, I was very appreciative of at the time. This is the opportunity to manage one of the most polarizing and prolific talents outside of a Howard Stern. So I was honored. And it's a shame that through all of that, and through all of what you really work hard to do, you realize that, damn, when you get to that point, some, you know, this, you know, it ain't everything. It ain't everything when it take away so much from something. And that's where everything went left. But again, I take full accountability and I stand on the principle of knowing that I did hurt somebody. And for that, I wish her nothing but the best, wellness, and support, and, you know, my deepest. With that being said, professionally, what I did, what I've done, what I contributed to, what I was a huge part of, what was, you know, what was stripped from me because of whom I choose to be with and whom I choose, like you're not supposed to, you know, personal relationships go on the job all the time, you know what I mean? And, you know, when it happens in everyday situations, you choose not to speak to somebody, oh, you still see somebody, you keep it moving. But when it's on this level of what me and her was and what was being created and cultivated, in some cases originated, like, you got to deal with that accordingly. And I know my general makeup to a lot of people might seem a certain way. You hear a lot of things about people who don't know me. It's a small group of people who do. And I'm not trying to prove nothing. The people that I have helped, the people that I have been instrumental of being a catalyst to, they know who they are. And, you know, I wish nothing but the best still. Even when you do me dirty, it's like, all right, God got me, I'm good. He brought me this far, he gonna keep bringing me. And I don't wish nothing bad on the situation, so that's why I remain quiet throughout. You know, when I did choose to share certain pertinent things, people decided they wanted to exploit, twist it, you know, all for clicks. That's all good. But God got me. He don't got you. To any event, what happened to me as an executive in a business that does not have a lot of diversity was not called for. And I struggled with whether I was going to pursue this, because after such a public divorce where everybody chose to do what they do in the movie, and which I feel was not a rightful depiction of the situation at all. You could have definitely spent more time on the real accomplishments and the defining moments that made her who she is. There's a lot of people that need to be thanking what she put down. From TMZ on down, when there wasn't no platforms and all these, you know, there wasn't no social media. But instead, you know, there was a bunch of hurt. There was a bunch of people using the opportunity to discredit, take a personal situation and discredit my hard work. Hard work where I never missed a day, maybe 3 days tops out of 10 years. She never missed one day. And because of that, the effects of that are happening now. See, if there's any other player, let's just say from a sport or what have you, and they happen to have a season where they're injured or whatever, you know, you give that person time to rehab and do what they need to do. But when you don't do that, then you risk more injury, more hurt, more pain.
Hey, Quiet Storm, what's up, girl?
I wanted, you know, I remained silent because I wanted the person that I was going through this with to not go through as much pain, you know, as it was causing with a deeper rooted issue at hand that everybody seems to have just thought just went into thin air. I didn't want that person to keep suffering. So I took whatever blows I needed to take, and I still was helping. So for all of you people that just think, you know, it's about taking something, in the midst of my divorce, I continue through the grace of God to save a person's life. Do me a favor, once I cut the light on. I continue to go through that, you know, because that's the type of person I am. So I never stopped being that person. But through the course of the divorce, one of the fastest celebrity divorces in history, because I basically left whatever on the table just to have peace of mind and wanted her to have peace of mind. In doing so, I still had to save life. I still had to save her life. And there's some people that very much know what I'm talking about, because they were responsible for almost seeing her life come to an end. There's current people in place, management, that clearly put her in a life and death situation and denied medical coverage and care. And if it wasn't for my son and myself stepping in, that's it. When I say step in, I mean when you got somebody telling, you know, my son, who's the most beautiful spirit on the place on this planet. You got people that's trying to objectify him right now, because all he wants is his mother well. He don't care about none of that. He grew up in front of all of this. He don't know nothing, but he want his mother well. Oh, you got somebody sitting there who just got there telling your son that no, you can't send these people up to a place to save her, to see, to do a real wellness check. Not this control stuff that's happening now. A real wellness check. You got somebody telling a 20-year-old that, to a point where he got to say, if you don't let these people upstairs to go look at my mom's, I'm calling 911. That's the only thing that allowed. For rescue is to get up there. And two blood transfusions later,
Jesus.
That queen's still here.
Ooh.
With people who, because of, I don't know if it's pride or narrative, or overall dissent, you know, I understand that there was a bunch of people around me that didn't want to be around me. I get it. I come from a certain place. I understand that there was a bunch of people that couldn't wait till I get out the way so that they can have their way. I get it. I didn't, you know, I understand. But the amount of people that knew exactly what was happening on my departure, and not making sure that certain steps was in place, because certain departments that's supposed to be, when you had a normal situation, you're supposed to have different departments to deal with somebody of this magnitude in case anything happens. So, i.e., you would have never seen this happen to Ellen DeGeneres. You would have never seen this happen to Jimmy Fallon. You don't hear about any of this stuff. But here, there's no installation for a person. And for the most part, there are people who absolutely know. And they know so much, they ready to, they know. So I'm not just saying that, like, I'm telling y'all this because at the end of the day, it wasn't about half of what anybody thinks. And I know I don't owe anybody or everybody an explanation. I'm just being forthright right now.
Thank you. Oh, and you're gonna always get it again and again and again, cause these bitches can't motherfucker get off of MC Depp.
That was one of the instances while getting dragged, you know, and it's cool. With that being said, professionally, when it comes to the lawsuit that I'm presenting, and what I waited, you know what I mean, to do, because I didn't know if I really wanted to go through anything after all this happened with the divorce. It's about the respect of what I did contribute creatively. It's about no disrespect to the people that came before and the people that clearly worked in the business longer than me, and I know that they never would have chose me. I had to inherit the situation, and I might not knew how to exactly produce a show, but I had to learn a lot real fast. And people, where I'm from, you have to adapt and learn stuff fast. So I adapted real fast, and I knew how to produce my peoples. In turn, she knew how to give the proper respect to me. And for that, I'm forever grateful. And a lot of people ain't understand that. A lot of women would want to say, oh, you should have did this, had that, whatever, whatever. I don't compare my situation to none of the other.
Shunama. Glory to God. Hey, but I thank God. God, look on right now. In the name of Jesus, healing hands, touch and deliver. Healing hands, touch and make whole. Hallelujah. Ha. Look on every man, every woman, every boy, and every girl. Hey, God, we came to praise you. We came to lift you up. We came to magnify.
Lord, I can't keep up with this man, Kevin. He's talking too slow for me, but I'm just going to sit here and listen, y'all. He starts stuttering a whole lot. He's apologizing. He's got a lot of karma that he's facing right now.
Powerful women, and they might earn more or do more, because it takes a foundation that's real for any of that to survive. And for all the ones that's doing it on their own, salute to you. But for the ones where the corporations come in and pretty much marry y'all, not the men that's out here really, you know, fighting and cherishing, but for the corporations that try to step in and become that's crazy. At the end of the day, I wasn't allowed to go get my belongings. I was objectified as some sort of monster because I chose to have an extramarital relationship. Tell me where they fire you for, okay, you had a regular job, you could just say, I don't want to deal with you no more. But where they fire you because you are not with somebody anymore after being such a successful part, an integral part. You might not want to really admit it, but if you didn't want me there, other things could have transpired. And you know, I would have been, I'm not going to stay in the way. It wasn't really the plan for me to be there that long anyway. I'm there to support my peoples and making sure it's right. She wanted me to be there, so I'm there. That's my peoples. I'm going hard for it. Like I go hard for my peoples now. That's just what it is. I know a lot of people understand why I chose to do what I did, whatever I did, and I don't really owe you no explanation. But to say that I go with realness and honesty and integrity, and I don't always be where the money's at. And whatever happened between me and my ex-wife happened way before. And you know what? We worked ourselves into a situation where we just either had to keep working or we was bound to crash. And that we did. In terms of her wellness to date, I'm totally supportive of my son, who is a beautiful spirit, a gentle giant, and will probably soon be objectified as some sort of monster, somebody that's trying to take advantage of his mother, even though he's her only heir. But he soon will be objectified like that. And you know what? He's not going to deserve that because he's not that. All of this for the sake of business and money. I understand the essentialness of all of that. I understand that, you know, things come to an end. But when you look at what happened in the interim of my departure, you could draw your own conclusions and understand that if the opposite would have happened and she would have flourished and been so much better without any of my involvement whatsoever, and I wish and pray that and hope that, you know, like she meets somebody and love continues and we still can be respectful with how we have to deal with whatever, because we do have a beautiful specimen of a son that still needs us. If it would have went the other way, I would nothing but applaud, and I probably would not even look to seek the respect that's rightfully mine as I struggle with even making this decision to go with this lawsuit. But all we wanted, all everyone needs is some peace and some time right now. And regardless of however her family might feel about me, I got nothing but love and respect for them. I wish them well. God bless them. There's a lot, you know, and I just God bless them all. Be part of my son's family. Look, I don't have no hate. Whatever hate I had, I left when I left New York, I left it there. Along with all the bad energy and frequencies. At the end of the day, the lawsuit is about anybody after me going through a somewhat similar situation and is fighting, you know, for their respect. No disrespect to the people that were supportive, but for anybody that really wasn't and you was there, then, you know, this is the product. This is like what the outcome is. And, you know, I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time because I'm not going to be jumping on this all the time. I can't say I'm taking no questions or anything like that. The people that I'm suing at Debmar Mercury, affiliated with Lionsgate, wrongful termination. At the end of the day, the people, the handlers, everybody that's surrounding the situation, there's a motive that's getting real ugly. And even for people that have grown to dislike, and they looking at this like this is some live TV show and you just enjoying the antics, just understand that the helm of all of this is someone that's really fighting, you know, for them.
I want to pause this real quick. Didn't Wendy Williams have some type of illness like we saw on the Lifetime special? Like children, she couldn't have like children. She had one, but she had some type of illness that I cannot remember. And I just got questions why people, the media, the Wendy Williams show, the husband, why he would put her through all of this. And some people feel like it's her karma from what she said about people. I do not know. All I know is that in the industry, they throw low balls. They really throw low balls, attack each other for entertainment reasons and everything. The blogs. Let me get back to the thing.
Yes. And wherever I stepped away and try to give them room to do and create, just so that, you know, without all of the hoopla. Like that's part of my legacy. Like my new legacy, that's also a part of me. That's part of me. You know? And I support Elizabeth. I salute Elizabeth Warren and her whole plight against the Wells Fargo system of banking and what's happening with these predatory people out here. And understand that whole fight, when you're dealing with these banks, it gets real crazy. It's a lot of people that are not in a position to have any kind of voice or platform, and the elderly or what have you, and they're getting preyed upon with their wealth or whatever they have. And if you want to narrow that down to how our people is ranked in that, then it's even worse. As far as, you know, again, thanks to Hunter Publishing for allowing me to be on this platform. You know, I could have did a whole lot of different things. You know, I'm going to probably repost this. You know, I just wanted to talk to y'all without a whole lot of extraness. I am going to start doing a few things to support.
You don't want
to
hear nothing that you got to
respectfully. and the amazing people that I'm working with.
After this one.
As far as, you know, as far as anybody else that's out there with the negativity and the people that's clicking and the people with the weird obsessions for me, look, I ain't got nothing but dust for them. I'm not on trying to make this a whole campaign.
You take that elsewhere. Don't bring that here.
A bride's dress covered in blood as she tended to multiple victims shot outside a popular nightclub in Baton Rouge.
It's a whole wedding, so who gonna be beefing? First of all, if you were beefing at a wedding, you should have been beefing at that wedding. Why would you bring this to somebody else's club? It's sad.
Hazel London was inside the club when she heard gunshots.
It's upsetting me and my homegirl, because we feel like, well, damn, if you can't go to Bellinoche's, where the hell could you go?
It's not like this all the time. Last week we were in Houston. It's not like this.
But they're willing to take the risk.
Actually, motherfuckers bring guns in their car all the time. You think we got time for somebody getting shot in a place we gonna have a good time in? No.
We'll be right back.
Okay.
Like, I got things I have to do and still accomplish for the legacy that is, you know, this is really what that's about too. I'm part of somebody else's legacy, and then I'm establishing my own legacy for both of my kids, my beautiful kids, and my current lovely situation with my partner. My friend, my confidant. I want to give a special love and support to Vegan Nose and Vish and all those platforms. And I'm honored to be part of that. When it comes to the support I got and continued support I will have no matter what, from near, from far, I wish nothing but the best in health and wellness, and know that the person that I know, as long as they stay focused and get to what's really important in your process when you're dealing with recovery, when you're dealing with any type of real trauma, you know, you just got to make it about yourself. The best thing that I could have did was make it about myself through this turmoil and focus more on the foundation. Because money is essential, but it definitely ain't everything. And the way that this world is going, it looks like you gotta have more than just money.
Celebrities are a trip.
Yeah, friend and confidant. That's my peoples. Serena Hudson. She's a warrior. She is.
That's shout out to Tasha K. She's the one that inspired me
and she is family.
Do the video.
And I do have family. And I will continue to have family. And my family is unfortunately what I make because of just how my whole family is. And, you know, that's a whole nother story. The support I will continue to have for my son, the support that I will continue to have for his mom.
Continue to focus on Blick,
no
and
what
we have a problem.
Takes place, you know, no matter like the stuff that y'all will never understand that goes on behind the scenes, and you know, no matter what type of picture someone tries to paint, just know that there's a lot that has happened.
Okay, cut the video. Oh my God.
And we will not rule out the fact that, you know, in a lot of.
What in the world? Why is he talking like this? Is this a drug or something? Because if he's a manager, how was he managing how was he managing Wendy Williams talking like this? Like the way he's talking, I need somebody to let me know really what's going on. Somebody that reads people a little bit more. Or either he just got a lot on his mind. I don't know.
Situations, you know, you could be worth more dead than alive. Depending on what kind of insurance policies and whatever people have. And I hope that God continue doing what he's doing to make, you know what I'm saying, make the impossible possible. And I hope he continue giving everyone out there that's supportive the strength to, you know what I'm saying, keep powering through everything that's happening in this crazy world right now. I understand that there's a lot of talk shows that's getting canceled, you know, because people are into so much nonsense. But through the trials and tribulations, there are some Jews that are brought. And you know, when Wendy was going through rehabilitation, let me be very clear. When she was being rehabilitated, an opportunity came for people to fill in her show 2 years ago when things were somewhat awry, and everyone knew it, including the people and her subordinates, and everybody knew it. When all that was happening and desperately had to fill in spots, I was very intricate in suggesting and telling them Nick Cannon is a very, very good choice. No disrespect. And while they were working with Jerry O'Connell, who's also a phenomenal talent, I said, Nick Cannon, and that turned into, you know, a whole thing. And, you know, I salute Nick Cannon, and it's unfortunate that, you know, you couldn't get the support that you needed. Whatever support that we received while I was there, the support that we received had to come by hook or crook, in a sense, with, you know, just pressuring and sometimes not coming across, you know, so likable. But I'm fighting for my family at the time. This is not just somebody I'm representing. There's so no disrespect to the managers that's out there that's really representing their people and going hard, and they would damn near die for their people. Well, this is my family, so I'm definitely in that position where I would die for mine. So I'm gonna go hard for mine. So when everybody else go home to their families, I gotta take this home and deal with everything. So I'm going hard. And what you've seen from season one in terms of aesthetic, style, not taking nothing away from the contributions, but when it comes to her personal, the personal style of it all, and what, you know, what needed to come across, because when you're not a sample size in daytime television, when you're not the size of Kelly Ripa and all of them, then you got to buy clothes. So what you've seen and how it was presented was all fighting behind the scenes for budget to open, to make sure that while the only person who could sit in a chair for 25 minutes a day, even against all the women, all the men, even the men in nighttime talk shows, late night talk shows, they don't have monologues that go for 25 minutes, 12 minutes tops. She's there for 25 minutes just engaging with these people. So you got to look the part. And she was the only person that still can do it effectively. No disrespect to anybody, her predecessors, people after her. I salute y'all. I wish y'all the best. But what had to happen in terms of the fight of sorts to get to that point was something. And I remember, you know, Shaquem Compare told me at the beginning of the journey, he said, look, there's not a lot of positive images of black people on television, man. So to make sure, that stuck with me. So that was my blood, sweat. Hello? Hello?
These people let money rule their lives.
Yes, I'm not on.
See how they fight no bone, Big Boys Club, Bad Boys Club.
Hello? I'm back. Listen, I'm not going to take up too much more of your time. Like I said, you know, whether it's 115 people, 1,000 people, it don't matter. You know, I ask people to spread it to the people that matter. And, you know, as long as you know, that's what's up. But, like I was saying, at the end of the day, a lot goes into being part of any kind of production, and I feel honored to have been part of it, but the way it all went down, they definitely could have been more professional about it, and I'm seeking my justice for my legacy, for everything that is me.
Hold on. If anybody needs this video, you can use it, or you can go to, I got it from Kevin Hunter's Instagram. If you click on his story, you can use the app and download it to your phone or whatever. So you can get this video if you need to play it on your channel. Hey, it's all hot air. Also, Tasha K, she's the first one that put it on YouTube. So you can also get it from her. You can get it from multiple places. Back to the video. Please like the bit. I'll do the thing. What's the thing, man?
Moving forward, I appreciate everybody's support, and you know, not just Hunter Publishing, but you know, the people that came and supported Loretto in Brooklyn, NYC, the people that hopefully you know is gonna support the new endeavor in Brooklyn. We're doing Caribbean Vegan. I will not continue to beat a drum, you know what I mean, when it comes to all of this. At some point, you know, if I get to writing a book, you know what I mean, and I feel like I've had enough memorable moments, I'll do that. I'm not trying to capitalize off of any hype, which is why I remain quiet. But this one here is just about respect. When you got people that you really help carve out something, you know, something hello, that you know 200 Mike, after 238 shows, you know, you that came and went. There's hello. Something stayed there, and you know, you don't give credit or respect. I just happen to be black, but you don't give credit or respect. That there's a problem with that. And you know, if there's someone else going through a divorce, or you know, and they happen to be an executive producer, and you give them all the room and time in the world to deal with their issue, but this situation here, you know, was just about you know, turning it and you know, into. On a reality show. For the people who are dwelling on the fact that I had a baby, a beautiful daughter, a beautiful, beautiful, smart daughter with a beautiful person, just know that at the end of the day, before there was any, and again, I take accountability for all my actions as a man. And I'm sorry that I hurt someone to that degree when it came to fulfilling a piece of my happiness. I've always been a family-oriented person, even though I'm not close with a bunch of my family. And I would have loved to create more family. But again, when you sacrifice, you know, the business, it's only people that's running a real race don't understand. When you're running a race, sometimes you don't find time or can foresee that if that's not part of your real foundation. And you know, for a long time, I thought that you know what, you get to somewhat of the top, because there was still some ways to go. When you get to somewhat of the top of a situation, and you think, yeah, this is what it is. Well, you know what? I've been fortunate enough to have a lot of stuff and do all that, but this is not what it is. A person need more than just this. They need foundation over everything. I've seen people with much less be more happier with their foundations, even where I'm at. And I'm sorry that the emergence of life, how I decided to bring it, hurt her and the whole stereotype of what happens when a man does that. I understand that you can't make everyone happy in that instance, but I do not regret what happened. I was not trapped into what happened. As a matter of fact, and again, I'm profusely apologetic for the impact it caused. I realize that, but as a matter of fact, the mother of my child, when we discovered it, she was like, no, you know, we don't need to. She was the first one to try to suggest an alternative, and I actually said no. And that's because of the joy that I needed to have in my life at the time. Because of whatever was happening at 100 miles an hour and happening right under me and around me, that, you know, from whatever type of control freak people paid me out to be, there was a lot of things I couldn't control. But yeah, I could have controlled my actions better if I chose to. But until you've been in my shoes wholeheartedly to understand exactly what I was dealing with, you can't tell me nothing. I don't know too many men that could have done exactly what I did. And I'm not trying to be cocky. I'm not trying to act like, I'm just saying the truth. I don't know too many people that could have done and bared the weight of what I did wholeheartedly. And I don't know too many people that could have did what she did. That's why she's standing on her throne no matter what. But for whatever we were supposed to be together as at a point where I fought for family many a days. I fought to bring my son here. I fought to try to keep an semblance of what the essence of family is. And I've been on my own since I was 15 years old. So whatever I'm trying to put together as family to be family first, I stood on that strong. And what happened? What happened is, you know, family didn't step that. Family wasn't a priority like it should have been. When you chase something more, when you when you chase something more and you start to forget, you know, what's important and what's like it's never supposed to be the other way around. Like it's supposed to be this first and we'll figure it out. We'll figure it all out no matter what happens. But when it's not that no more and you got a million people and devils and serpents and snakes and salamanders and all that, you know, trying and feeding and enabling. And let's be clear. The enabling happened at an all-time high when I was desperately trying to get right. I don't care how much partying we done did and drinks, whatever. You get to a point where you got to get right. But when people want to keep you in a certain state, they enable. you know, and there was enabling happening clearly after my departure. There was enabling happening towards the end of my departure. And there were people that basically were saying, like, you know, even though we know there's a certain level of help needed, we're not getting behind it. We're not supporting that. We just want to make sure.
Cause I'm on white, man. Hey, Mr. White Dyer, Fossil Millio. This would be the remix.
All right, good job.
Fossil Millio, man. I know what it is. We still on, we still riding right wrong. We still putting on white, man. I pull up at the club, VIP, gas tank on. But all drinks on me, white. Fresh kids, fresh white, tall teeth, fresh NFL hat, fresh bows with the grease, white. Pussy niggas, pulling niggas with the heat. Real niggas don't speak, white. Chicken lady, I've been golden by the week. You can tell I got cake by the diamonds in my boots, white. Black shade, so you know a nigga rolling. They ain't check man, to go, so ain't no telling what I'm holding, white. Bad bitches, they gon' bust it wide open. Niggas flashing in the bread, but I'm the nigga they approach, white. Small nigga, tall figures, y'all niggas, crawl niggas. We gon' get Mac 11s and dog niggas, white. Y'all niggas, call niggas, put my nigga.
Back to this boring nigga. Too tired nigga. He better hope his, remember his son fought him? They said over on Tasha K's comment section that the boy, the son got all of the rights. And he trying to get all smooth with his son now. But his son remember what he done did. And I hope that they have a good relationship, but it all remains to be seen. I'm sure the blogs already know. Back to the video. And what? Did y'all say something? He sound as slow, as dumb as Andrew Caldwell.
We just want to make sure that she, you know, that she can do it. So, you know, when you got so many things stacked and then as soon as you get out of the way, soon as you know, you can say, hey, if I place myself out of the way, if you think I fucked up the bag or whatever you want to say, like at the end of the day, the blessings came tenfold. I wanted my son to have another sibling on this earth so that he can have somebody else to count on. So I have some immediate family. I want him to have blood. To get specific about a lot of things, again, one of the many things that I did, you know, during the divorce, in the midst of, not just before the divorce, I'm talking about during, was very integral in helping my son save his mom's life. While current management was ready for her to die. Leaving her to die, imminent danger. And was on call. And if you really want to keep it funky, that's, you know, the whole situation with DJ Booth, and that's, you know, shouts to you, my dude, but to keep it funky, like, you know, he called me. I had to ask him why. He said, because he couldn't call anybody else. A whole staff of people there. And she's in a damn near a state that is crazy. People know she's in this state. People have seen what happened. They see she's broadcasting from the house. You seeing what's happening. Because it's
blood transfusion.
Don't do anything. You just cut off the feed. And leave the DJ guy, who happened to think fast, manning everything in the house. Where they do that at? You think if Ellen or somebody is broadcasting from their house that, you know, they would do that? Or Jimmy Fallon? Or the cast of The View? You would have at least 5 or 6 people on call. No, it was just Booth. And when he called me and told me what was happening, there was another individual that was there, that was there and knew, it was damn near like family, that happened to jump in and see and help save. Wow. Management sat back and just let it all just happen. So, current management, y'all do the math, y'all figure it out. Current and only management sat back. I happen to have been in New York taking care of something before I got to come back down here and start my life. My son is in Florida. You got to get an emergency medical team to come in and try to, a private one. And you got this guy denying coverage.
I need to play my song.
He's denying coverage for this person to come on this, to come upstairs, for these people to come upstairs and save this woman's life. So when my son got a threat and said, I'm going to call 911 if you don't let them up.
What's his name?
You never decided to call in the midst of everything. You didn't even call to see about what previous doctor she might have had that I had knowledge of. You didn't try to follow up with none of that. So whatever went awry, and now you got a person that's just getting ready to, you know. You got a person that's getting ready to damn near die. And they got to have 2 blood transfusions later. But these are also the same people that in the midst of the whole breakup and a distraught person, emotionally distraught person, they decided to pick the management. They, you know, like a real conflict of interest. They bring in people that they got in pocket to be involved. So now the whole control game is at an all time high. It's all about control. They don't care if somebody gets well. They don't care if somebody is functional. It's about control. And the control that they felt they had after I left, the control they thought I had when I was there, and that was my ex-wife. This person was going through some real stuff before any baby news or anything happened. This is some real stuff happening, and I'm not trying to diss. It ain't about dishing. This is about understanding what a person got to go through. I've had many people in my family, my immediate family, go through stuff. And if whoever is on here who have remotely a family member that's really went through something, it's you know. And just because you got money and you go through a whole, you know, masquerade stuff with, you know, makeup and that, you know, when you take all that off, the person that you are is who you are.
Keep it real, that makes you feel worse. May be a lost cause, but they still search. Until the day I die holding my gun shot. Rather have a funeral than be with one alive. Get the bird box, I want to see my brother fly. No longer shackled.
I left a lot on the table. You know, y'all don't have to worry about any haters or whoever coming in here trying to, you know, you know, at the end of the day, I'm not going to give that person any type of energy. And she know who she is, but, you know, whatever, yo. You obviously have some weird obsession. And you really are unfactual. And we know that you lie, so it's all cool. Like, I'm just here trying to talk some truth, and I am going to repost this. It's unfortunate that I couldn't do it on my page because, you know, people doing all kinds of craziness, reporting me. I'm not really doing anything, but, you know, I appreciate coming on here and being able to let you know what it is. No, I am not getting back together with my ex. I'm currently cool. I'm happy. I wish her well. You know what I mean? I'm in my zone. I'm in my relationship. You know,
and a baby.
Someone that's a rider, no matter what anybody wants. Think.
Right.
I'm trying to surround myself with good people that
right.
that don't have ulterior motives and ain't just around. You know what I'm saying? I'm still Kelvin Hunter. I'm cool with that. I'm still Kev. I'm appreciating Kelvin. I'm looking at that as a new lease on life. My Ooh. Health and wellness is not a shtick. Ever since, you know, what me and my son went through. And let me be clear about that, just to add some clarity. Because I just recently heard something. When it comes to what my strong young king has been through in his life, such a special spirit, special genuine spirit, who's still learning his bumps and lumps, but special nonetheless. What we had to endure as a family at the time, you know, while he went through his ordeal that was shared with millions and kind of misconstrued because he never had any addiction to anything. He just happened to, no different than if I smoked some weed for the first time and I just get sleepy and hungry. Well,
yep, the alimony.
The same experience. Because
he wants the alimony.
And what he was.
That's what this is all about.
He's very knowledgeable of it now.
Oh my God. So
I'll teach him whatever he needs to teach. No, I'll teach him whatever he needs to know. And all the fundamentals of what he needs to know that he allowed me to. But what he went through as a result of digesting that and what we had to do at the time, what Wendy's contribution along with myself to trying to save my son's life was, what she tirelessly did for her family to a point where, you know, what she tirelessly did was something short of extraordinary during the time when my son was going through what he was going through. Because we wasn't even going through it in the same country. We had to go to Honduras to deal with this whole issue. God bless the dead. Dr. Sabi is probably the last person, one of the last people that he healed was my boy. And what his mom had to endure, you know, what I didn't want her to endure on the other side, being in the jungle. What I knew, what she could handle and what she couldn't handle. In hindsight, she probably needed to be there the most. But for as fragile as the situation was, she was not for good merit and for the business that we plagued ourselves with the business that we inundated ourselves with and not taking more time out. Because if we would have, maybe that would never happen to my son. But I had to go. And yes, my peoples, the mother of my child was very intricate in helping me through that process when I had nowhere to turn. And I couldn't necessarily put that pressure on someone who already was dealing with immense pressure. I know a lot of y'all won't understand that. That's okay. But again, this is about truth. So the truth is, I try to do the best I can at in my weakest moment in life, because at the time I thought my son was going to die. And if it wasn't for the people this who all fun. Played a part. He would not be here. Or he would have had to suffer. He don't have to suffer now. And now he's fighting a vigilant fight to make sure that his mom's is good beyond anything. So it's not about getting back to what everybody wants. It's about getting back to yourself and making sure it's good. Through what happened to my son, many people got affected in a positive way. He don't know how much of a vessel, an oracle of sorts that he was. So many people got touched from him and his ordeal. When we had to change our diets 10 years ago, because him coming back from there, he couldn't eat regular food, so we had to try and all unite to help him. Now that same fool is helping getting his mom well. That same fool has kept me from being in and out of doctor's offices and with high blood pressure and all that other stuff. And what he's been able to do for many people around him is something short of extraordinary. So no matter what they try to tell you or paint a picture of when it comes to that boy, just know that that boy is special. He's special. That young man is special. And no matter what happens, hopefully the respect levels will stay to a degree where, you know, he can have both his parents in his life.
Hallelujah.
I think that's enough, P. I want to give love to all the people that I'm currently in business with, from everybody at Hunter Publishing, all the authors, and the people that's allowing me to handle their projects, to my restaurant partners, Original Prime, you know, my dude Finesse, man, I got mad love for you, my dude, the whole family. I wanna give a shout out to my dude Grandma Uwe Music, y'all be on the lookout for that. They about to make major moves. There's gonna be a few more things that pop up in the course of.
Remember when he came
to that? You know how this is evolving out. And I ask y'all to really use your third eye when you're thinking about and seeing what's going on.
Don't
look at things on the surface, y'all.
It was terrible. Has he married that other girl?
Somebody's sitting here wringing their hands. Don't think somebody sitting up here being driven by some money. Because if I really wanted to be on that, it's a lot I could have did. It's a lot everybody around me could have did. And I finally could say from the people that did do me dirty, from the people that I'm content with what's around me right now. Enough that I could get on here and talk, and hopefully I ain't talk too much craziness. This will prepare me for whatever war or fight that's ahead of me and the fam. People who know me know that, you know, regardless of what picture is painted, I stand tall in what I believe in and who I believe in. What I believe in and who I believe in. And you know, that's about it. I want to give a special, you know.
Oh, Jocelyn Hernandez.
Special thanks to that angel queen.
Where is that at?
When it comes to Miami Entertainment Law Group, Sean Thomas, people don't even understand. When you got somebody who really, really ride, who really, you know, everybody, yeah.
I think Jocelyn Hernandez, y'all, apologized. Let me see if I saved that. This was last night. These people stay up all night long. Does anybody know where that is? Did she go to Twitter? Lil Baby got caught. That girl released the DMs. Jolanda. Chief Keef's other baby mama said she's the one who had him and provided receipts. So if you look, they have the screenshot of you in my city. And they look at where you at. Scottsdale. Pull up. Where? Oh, Lord. But do y'all know where that is? I thought I saved it, but I don't know why these folks like that. I know about Wendy because I used to watch her all the time, and her story was big when it first happened. If he married her, his alimony stops. Yeah, you're right. It will stop. Look at all of his businesses he started with her money. Well, I hope the courts look at this and makes an example out of Wendy and lets other women know when you get rich, you need to handle your business. I hope they make an example out of her. I mean, she may be coming back to TV, but it's time for her to make some statements on TV because I would be so embarrassed being on TV and ignoring what has happened to me. Anyway. I'm a fan where Jocelyn Hernandez basically is apologizing.
It's about money and business, and that's what make it go around. When you got people that go that extra mile for you like that, to a point where they'll go, what's being framed right now, what's happening right now, in order to give people their closure and their real peace, it's something short of amazing. And you know, Sean Thomas, you are amazing, and you know the people that are against that. And they're committing all those heinous acts and trying to paint that picture. The people that's trying to take away from somebody who worked hard their whole life to you know, even if it killed, even if it dissolved some of the most important relationships in their life, whatever, including me, like you don't want to think that the people that you're working the hardest for and making more money off of it than you will put you in a position where you look and being treated like some invalid. when you got to be pushed around in some wheelchair and fed in shores, and you clearly not there yet. Nothing against insure. Health is wealth. There's much more things you can put in your body. And right now, the person that you seeing, and I'm talking about my ex-wife, the person that you seeing now moving around and getting her wit about her and her wind beneath her feet is all due to my son's relentless work of changing around what was happening. Changing around something that was beginning to be real evil. So again, pray for him. Pray for me and mine. You know. Pray for yourselves.
Is it over? I think it's about over because I don't hear nothing from him. I don't know where it is.
All I know is that
oh, it may be on my Twitter. Well, that ain't going too good. So everybody have a great day. I'm not finding that good at all. The word apology is not in it. It's something else going on. But y'all let me know if y'all find out about this, the rest of the Jocelyn Hernandez thing, because somebody's feeling guilty or something's going on with the rest of that. Y'all know that they put in the rib cage, broke their ribs, Amber's ribs, and all of that kickback that's being done, pushback that's being done right now to Zeus Network and being sued in court. So I had seen something about Jocelyn. She really is sick of it right now. Because why would she get in the comments and be like, you can't sue nobody that signed a contract? And everybody's like, girl, are you crazy? You can't commit a crime and then talking about a contract. So, all right.
Let me go see if the Fifi music video, and I'll see y'all. Have a great day. Thank you all for coming by. Like the video.
Bitch like me, keep on wishing, baby. Bust it open first, you got to kiss it, baby. Yeah, want another nigga, I go fishing, baby. Yeah, I never let these broke ass niggas fix me, baby. Yeah, I hop on top and ride that dick, I get lazy. Get the pussy, soak it wet, it's dripping like the Navy. Yeah, I call him Big Daddy, he call me Lil Baby. I'm the shit, I need some tissue, babe. Hey, holla, holla, holla. All these diamonds different color, color, color. I done ran up all these comma, comma, commas. Eat the cookie like another butter, butter. Lick this pussy like this fella, la, 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 la. Island team, she a Bahama, mama, mama. Do whatever for a dollar, dollar, dollar. Gucci snake up on my collar, collar, collar. Fuck that nigga, never get up.
Hoes ain't fucking with Barbie. Tay did my pink Bob Marley. I got a whole army as Charlie. Pull up with a killer, he the Joker, I'm Harley. Miss Unchunky Barbie. Me Onika Tanya. Well, these PR stunts, but bitch, you ain't Puerto Rican, yeah. Fresh two, guess who? Drip need a wetsuit, one and a two. Give a fuck about the next few. Step one, force me, there won't be a step two. Come through with some bitches that's bad, they gon' step two. Ain't nigga tryna pop, ain't the next boo. Then run up in my DM, RIP the X2. Check who, niggas that really spin your block if the queen send a text through. Texting with Jeff Bezos, bout to cop new Dracos. Ops is on the block, we bout to spin it like tornadoes. I'm bout to piss, yeah, I call him Big Daddy, he call me Lil Baby. They know I'm the shit, I need some tissue. Bitch like me, keep on wishing, baby. Bust it open first, you got to kiss it, baby. Yeah, want another nigga, I go fishing, baby. Yeah, I never let these broke out. Watch it, bitch, bitch. Yeah, yeah, Miss Unchunky Barbie. Me up, watch it, click, click. Yeah, push it, click, click. I said, push it, click, click. Yeah, pop up on the up it, watch it, click, click. Yeah, push it, click, click. Yeah, pop up on the up it, watch it, click. Yeah, want a bad bitch like me, keep on wishing, baby. Bust it open first, you got to kiss it, baby. Yeah, want another nigga, I go fishing, baby. Yeah, I never let these broke ass niggas fix me, baby.
Watch it, bitch.
up if you ain't Puerto Rican, yeah. Fresh suit, guess who? Don't need a wet suit, one and a two. Give a fuck about the next dude. Step one, force me, there won't be a step two. Come through with some bitches that's bad, they on step two. Ain't nigga tryna pop in the next group. Don't run up in my DM, RIP to X2. Check who? Niggas that really spin your block, the clues in the text too. Then with Jeff Bezos, about to cop new Draco. Ops is on the block, we about to spin it like tornadoes. I'm about to put some Louis Vuitton on my Lambo. You know you bad when you can post from any angle. You said the upgraded LOL, did you really? But I just turned Mr. Paddock and then hold on. All these diamonds different color. I'm the leader, bitches follow. I created this shit, tell it. La.
Push it, click. Pop up on the app, watch it, click.
Push it, click.
See ya.
Pop up on the app, watch it, click. I said, push it, click. Yeah, pop up on the app.